You know what's cracking me up? So I know all of you have seen that video of a pastor who's, you know, it's gone viral. Apparently he raised someone from the dead, blah, blah, blah. Well, here's a twist to that nonsense. Oh, Jesus. Why are you? When is Jesus coming back? I just want to know. Send us a note. Jesus. And this same guy who apparently raised this guy from the dead, this pastor is called Lakau, I mean, something like that. Did you know that he did the same bollocks in South Africa about 2 years ago? And in South Africa, he claimed that he had healed an entire ward hospital, like an entire hospital ward. It had children, old, young. He healed all of them and they got up and ran. But the thing though about that particular hospital is that it had no hospital monitors, no cables, no switches, no sockets. You know how busy a hospital room can be? Nothing. And I see this ish starting in Uganda too. Man, it's like y'all don't even understand the difference between religion and faith. You don't even get it. Like, most of you are based on religion. Like, your faith is so lacking. Woo! And then some of you, your faith is way too much. You're willingly giving it to anyone and everyone. Man, I cannot with these pastors. But I say, next time I find out a pastor is playing, he playing with the with the flock. Oh no, we're finna lynch someone. I can't do this anymore. Like, we need to make an example out of these people. I believe we need to make an example out of these guys. Either they get incarcerated for life, for fleecing, for flinging. Like, tattoo sobola bikola bina. We can't. We can't. Put the book down, people. It will mess you up. It will. Anywho, my name is Cedafia Swan and welcome to Skip and Skip. I happened to chance upon Sheba. Sheba, yeah, she was on TV. She's getting an interview, and then I think I don't know how it escalated to that part, but she gets to a point when she's like, you see, Ugandans Ugandans love our music, but they do not respect us, they do not love us, and I do understand that, okay, yes, we are celebrities and all of that, and like when we mess up, it's always in the public because we're in the public eye, but we're also human. Like, today I'm cock studio, I'm about to treat Nganga by superstars. Name by Uganda, you just don't know how to treat your artists. Kogamba, today I'm cock studio, I'm about to treat Nganga by superstars. Did you get the drift? Did you? Oh, Sheba. Sheba Sandiaga, the work of a museum. Like, if there's anybody who has gotten the respect and the love of Ugandans, if there's anybody who has left the Ugandans seated there like, you know what, that's Sheba, she finna do whatever she like, we'll just like her music. It's you, you can't even. Mm-mm. The only person who is entitled to this particular concept and what you're putting out there, like two people, Bebe Kula and Chameleon. Bebe and you get them, but we don't respect them, but you Sheba. And then what's this nonsense of comparing us to Coke Studio? How do you compare an entire nation with an organization? Like, I don't get it. Of course, they're supposed to treat you like superstars up in there. Because you're going to make them a lot of money. Yes, boo-boo, you're going to make a lot of money for them. Now, for us, I do not understand why we should respect you. All we need to do is love your music. When we love your music, it's in rotation. When it's in rotation, you're making your money. So yes, bish, you are supposed to respect us. You should not even care how we treat you, or if we love you, or if we respect you. No, secure your bag. That's the reason you joined music, isn't it? You badly wanted to join music. It's a cutthroat business. Like, tuleke mu. Jeez. But anyway, to be honest, I do feel her pain. No, I don't. I mean, I'm sorry. I don't. I want to feel the pain of this. Like, every time you talk to an artist, they're like, yo, people, you forget that we're also human. We did not forget. You're the one forgetting that you're also human when you're out there doing these things. We're finna watch. Now, you're not just regular human, you are celebrity human, so we are going to judge. Because it takes us to make you celebrity. Now, if we're in numbers, that's how you become celebrity. Because let's just say, if only three people knew Sheba's music, would she be talking like this? No, she would not. but the whole country knows your music. Now you're talking like this. Do you get the analogy here? Like, you're human, blah, blah, blah. We should judge you lightly, idiota. Guess what? Your life's our entertainment. When you decided to be an entertainer, you decided to all-round entertain us. Whether it's you holding a microphone or you holding a man, it doesn't matter. We are going to definitely watch your life as an entertaining show. So I don't even think in this day and era, for the number of years you have spent in the industry, Sheba, you shouldn't even be saying nothing about love and respect. Like, if you want respect, get respect from your peers, not from the people who are making you earn all this money. Why should I respect you? Like, seriously, Sheba. And maybe the term was used very loosely. What is respect? Because, Sheba, when you come to a concert, tukuleka no yimba, tetukukubanga kobuchupa, buza bebekuli, I mean something about disrespect. So I'm just... I'm perplexed. I think these celebrities are starting to take us for a joyride. Eh? I think artists are starting to go back to their old demanding ways. That's you being entitled. Like, take what we give you and deal with that. Now, whenever you want to feel like a superstar, here's a plan. How about you move into the Coke studio? Can't you ask them the rest of the year when the house is empty, what do you do with it? Like, go again there, yo. They treat you like a superstar and respect you and love you and all those things. Woyagala tukuwembe, jetulinaga zibu gafenga egwanga. Tetugenda kuda kubizibu vyoshiba. You're living a good life. Shut up. You just moved into your beautiful apartment. You're making tons of money. You're taking vacations that half of the Ugandan crowd and masses can never do. So why would you even complain? You should just stand up and say, "Banaiba fani bange mbagala nyomwebale obamtuvumo bamkoze mtetwe yanziza." Because we have made all these things possible. Boo. As much as it was your hard work, it's the fact that we're taking your hard work that you have a bag to secure. So calm down. Jeez, I'm being petty.
I guess to Charlie Cook Studio, Kwanga Chakabona Beba to Teguno, Kanga Mweku Yamizimu, Kamweku Yakanga Mwera Zenyo, man.
It's just Cook Studio, and then next year again, Dakuba. You ask Lydia Jasmine. She has been to how many Cook Studios? Like two seasons, right? And she's still a struggling artist. Like, calm down, pipe it down. Anyway, this one wasn't even in regards to just Cook Studio. So King Saha graced us in the Cook Studio, and I was so. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. Like, when Saha sings, he really does sing. That's one thing you can't take away from him. Then, you unforgiving Ugandans took a minute to actually agitate him by saying, one, King Saha alimu nyumbe yonayetu, alimu studiezo na yen, can't speak English because he had to use the aid of an interpreter. Now, this is where it got fun. When they got King Saha, who couldn't speak English, and put him next to another person, I think from Ethiopia, who also couldn't speak English, no la bembaga. But I'm like, you know what? Let Saha be. You know? Saha is the one artist I know who just minds his business. You don't come for him, he won't come for you. If you don't send for him, he won't send for you. Like, let the guy be. How many of you didn't know that he can't speak English? Watch him where isako we muti. Watch him where isako. You know what? I actually bumped into him personally just a few days ago. We didn't exchange words. We didn't talk or anything. But it seems like a cool cut. Just needs to feed a little bit more because it seems like the hair is taking the rest of him. But I'm just more like a guy. He's having a blast. He's having the time of his life. Let him enjoy it. Did he ever think when he started music that he would be there? No, I don't think so. Let Saha enjoy his shine. And for all of you who are saying, you know what, all these songs that he's releasing were radios. No, Saha has been writing for quite some time, by the way. Like, I'm just saying, let us not be enemies of progress. Let us give chance. It's his time. Mumuleke, it's like someone trying to take John Black's shine right now. Like, what's your problem? Let him have his 15 minutes of fame. Whether he do it right or do it wrong, let him have his 15 minutes of fame. And that's what I'm going to say. Because all of y'all who's out here making all the nya, 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 there is not a Saha song that plays and you don't sing along to it. Like, he is that meticulous with his songs. Like, he will wait and be like, I'll hold on to this and then I'll release this. And whatever he releases, beautiful. Mumuveko, luzungu. Mubuze kenzo, weyaka igalu muyambie. Chachano nyabi iti. So, like, I cannot with you people. I can't. Don't look at me trying to fight someone's battles. It's sad, but beautiful still. Like, nze nchogeranga bwe chiri. Abana Uganda mulekera okwesa we nyonga. Nange muntu alide. Twesawo nyo. We think we have to have a certain over what? Anyway, you know what? Leave Saha alone and watch Coke Studio. It's dope. It's like dope. It's, for me, it's like the only vocally inclined person there for me right now. Yeah. Anywho, that has been my time of pettiness. And some shade throwing. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle. You can catch me on Instagram. That's at Tina Fierce One with an H. You can also get me on Facebook. That's at Tina Fierce One and at Scoop and Scoop. It's quite that simple, people. I'll catch you again tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.